Good morning, children. I am Ruchika from Springfields Public School. Today we are going to do lesson number 3, The Brog of LR. The Brog. Brog is the name of a horse. The Brog, written by Saki, is an interesting story. It is all about a family who have tradition that a brog must be sold before the hunting has come to an end. But the mullets, the family who practices the tradition, were not able to do it. It's page number 1 of this lesson. Mullets wanted to sell the brog. They were not able to sell it. Hunting season was over, but still the horse was theirs. The animal had been named Crazy One at first. He was later renamed the Brog. Someone suggested that the first letter of the name, that is B, was unnecessary. Rogue, R-O-G-U-E, meaning a wild, bad person, was even more suitable. Toby Mullet was the rider of the horse. The Brog's manner and characteristics were not ideal for hunting. According to the Mullet family, he was not really afraid of roads, but there were one or two things which caused him to jump about rather wildly. He would ignore motor cars and bicycles, but pigs, wheelbarrows, stones, baby carriages, and very wide gates all made him start off suddenly in clear imitation of lightning zigzag calls. Next page, children. It was already the third week in May when Mrs. Mullet, mother of Tommy, and number of daughters ran into Clovis Sangrail in the village. She told him all the news, speaking with great excitement. She criticized Mr. Pendricard. Who is Mr. Pendricard? A rich man. She said that Toby, his son, sold him the brog. Clovis said it is a good thing, but Mrs. Mullet said it is the worst thing happened in their life. She said that Mr. Pendricard likes her daughter, Jessie. She continued that at a garden party yesterday, Mr. Pendricard asked Jessie what her favorite flowers were. Jessie told him that she liked roses. And then a whole stack of roses arrived with a box of chocolates that he must have got from London. Next page, number 29. And Mr. Pendricard asked her to go play golf with him. And now Toby has sold him that horse. It's a disaster. Children, Mrs. Mullet was worried. Clovis responded and said that you have been trying to get rid of the horse for years. Mrs. Mullet said that she has 6 daughters. Clovis said frantically that she had never counted. Mothers generally know these things. Mrs. Mullet continued in her dramatic voice. When there is a rich man who might actually marry Jessie, Toby sells him that horse. If he rides on the brog, that terrible animal will probably kill him. What is to be done? They, that is Mullet's family, could not tell him the truth because they praised it so much and said that it was a wonderful animal. Something must be done. The man is not used to horses, and I believe I told him it was as quiet as a lamb. After all, lambs go kicking and twisting about as if they were mad, don't they? Clovis agreed on it. The lamb has an entirely false reputation for calmness.
Now come on page number 30. It was next day. Jessie came back from the golf game. Both looked happy and worried. Jessie said that Pendricard proposed him and she accepted. And then she said, he is coming over this evening to ask permission. I told him the story about how much he wanted to buy the horse back, but he seems very set on keeping it. He is going to start riding tomorrow. Jessie also said that Pendricard has experience with horses. He rides a few times before this, and tomorrow he is going to ride the dog. Jessie started crying. I shall be a widow before I am married, and I do so want to see what Greece is like. It looks so silly on the map. Vincent has promised to take me to Greece for our honeymoon. Clovis was sent for immediately and told the situation. Next page, page number 31. Mrs. Mullet said that nobody can ride that horse with any safety except Toby, because he knows everything about the horse. What frightens it? Jessie interrupted and said that she did hint to Mr. Pendricard that the brog didn't like wide gates. Mrs. Mullet exclaimed, "Did you mention what effect the pig has on him?" Toby said that the brog's taken a dislike to turkeys lately as well. Clovis said that it is clear Pendricard must not be allowed to go out on that animal, at least not till Jessie has married him. An idea came in her mind to ask him to a picnic tomorrow, starting at an early hour. He is not the sort to go out for a ride before breakfast. The brog will be standing idle in the stable, and Toby can offer to exercise it. Then it can pick up a stone or something of the sort and become lame. If they hurry on the wedding a bit, the lameness story can be kept up till the ceremony is safely over. It was nobody's fault that it poured with the rain next morning, making picnic impossible. It was also nobody's fault, but plain ill luck, that the weather cleared up in the afternoon so that Mr. Pendricard could try his first ride with the brog. They did not get as far as the pigs at Lockshire's farm. The church gate was painted a dull green. Earlier it was white. Now it was painted a dull green. But it had been a white a year or two ago, and the brog never forgot he had been in the habit of making a violent turn, twist and jump at this particular point of the road. Then he broke his way into someone's garden, where he found a turkey in a cage. Later the garden's owner found the cage almost whole, but very little left of the turkey. Page number 32. Mr. Pendricard was a little shaken and suffered from a hurt knee and some other damages. But he good-natured blamed his own inexperience with horses. Mr. Pendricard didn't blame anyone. He blamed his own inexperience with horses and country roads. In the list of wedding presents, which the local newspaper published a week or so later, appeared the following item. What has been written in the newspaper? Just see. Brown riding horse, the brog, the bridegroom's gift to the bride. Which shows that he knew nothing. This is said by Toby Mullet. Then Clovis said, or else that he has a very pleasing sense of humor. Now children, read this lesson again to make you understand the story and learn the word meanings of this lesson. Thank you so much, and stay home, stay safe.